I'm S. B. Parmar from Deep Coaching Class, and now we will continue again with 10th trigonometry level 2 questions. Last part we had done the level 1 questions. Same questions, same complementary angle identities, the values we will have to use, and we will have to solve these questions. Now see, here the question is given, that is LHS and RHS, two sides we have, and we will have to prove both the sides equal. So we will start with LHS. This I will multiply here, this I will multiply here, because as it is LCM denominator, so we will have to make the denominator same. Okay, so cos A cos A cos square A plus 1 plus sin A 1 plus sin A, that is 1 plus sin A whole square, and in denominator 1 plus sin A into cos A. Cos square A as it is plus 1 plus 2 sin A plus sin square A. This is the square of this 1 plus sin A whole square. Evaluation 1 plus sin A into cos A. Cos square A plus sin square A, that is 1. And this 1 as it is plus 2 sin A upon 1 plus sin A into cos A. 1 plus 1, 2, and here also 2. So 2 I am taking common. Okay, I am writing whole only, so you people will not be confused. Denominator same only, no change. Now here from these 2, 2 common. So 1 plus sin A by 1 plus sin A into cos A. Okay, so this 1 plus sin A upon this 1 plus sin A. Cut. So that is 2 upon cos A, which can be written 1 by cos A. And we know that reciprocal of cos, that is sec. So twice sec A, which is our RHS. Okay, what did I do? At first, I have taken the LCM, then evaluation of this, then identity I have used, that is 1, then 2 common, same nominator denominator cut, and at last 1 upon cos A, that is the reciprocal of sec A. So we got our RHS is equal to sec A. Question 2, under root 1 plus sin A upon 1 minus sin A. Okay, so LHS we will take, and here I am going to do rationalization to solve this question. Earlier also in so many questions, rationalization we have done, and you know that rationalization means whatever is our denominator, inverse of that we are multiplying in numerator also and in denominator also. So this will become under root of 1 plus sin A whole square upon 1 square minus sin square A. Okay, means this one is A plus B whole square, and in numerator it is A plus B whole square, and in denominator it is A square minus B square, and even it is in the under root. Okay, so now square and rotation, so that we are removing. So 1 plus sin A, okay, upon 1 minus sin square A, that is cos A, na? Cos square A under root. So definitely, okay, right now I am keeping only, and then we will remove. Understood? Now this I am taking out of my root. Rotation is also there and square is also there. So that will be reduced only because square, and then after rotation, that means raised to 1 by 2. Na? So that 2 will be cut off. And cos A square root, that is cos A only. So this we can write like 1 by cos A into sin A by cos A. And that is our 1 by cos A is sec A plus this plus tan A, which is our RHS. Okay? What we have done? Rationalization we have done. So 1 plus sin a whole square and square root. Okay, like this it was, na? 1 plus sin a whole square and then after rotation means 1 by 2. So that is cut. So we got 1 plus sin a only. So 1 upon cos a plus sin a upon cos a. Na? We can write like this because denominator is same only. So 1 plus 1 by cos a, that is sec a, plus sin by a, that is tan. Okay? Next question. Sin a plus cosec a whole square plus cos a plus sec a whole square is equal to cot square a plus tan square a plus 7. So LHS, first we will take sin a square, that is sin square a, plus 2 sin a into cos a, 2 sin a into cosec a plus cosec square a. Okay, this one part we have solved. Now second part, cos square a plus 2 cos a into sec a plus sec square a. Okay, whole square formula we have applied, nothing else we have done. Now this sin square a plus cos square a, that is 1 sin square a plus cos square a. So 1 I can keep plus this 2 sin a into cosec a, that means 1 by sin a only, plus cosec square a. We can also write 1 plus cot square a. We have the identity na, cosec square a plus cot square a is equal to 1. Sorry, cosec square a minus cot square a is equal to 1. So cosec square a is equal to, we can write 1 plus cot square a, na? Plus 2 cos a, same. Sec is also 1 upon cos a plus sec, also identity I am writing only, 1 plus tan square a. Okay, this one reduction. So 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus cot square a plus 2 plus 1 plus tan square a. 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 plus cot square a plus tan square a, which is your RHS. Understood? What we have done? We have just evaluated with the whole square formula. The identities we keep. Na? Cosec square a, we have the identity cot square theta minus cosec square theta is equal to 1. So cosec square theta is equal to 1 plus cot square theta. And same for tan also we used, because sec square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. So sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. The same identities I kept here and here, and at last we got our RHS. Understood? Next question. If sin theta is equal to 12 by 13, then we have to value of this. Okay. So sin theta is equal to 12 by 13. Our right angle triangle. Okay. Triangle ABC we take. B is right angle triangle. And suppose angle A is our theta. Sin theta is given. Sin theta means opposite side, so theta ki opposite side is BC, and 12 upon hypotenuse, AB we will have to find. So how will we find it? AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square, that is our Pythagoras. Base square plus altitude square is equal to hypotenuse. So 12 square, sorry, this we don't have, so this we are keeping as it is only. 12 square is equal to 13 square, so that is AB square is equal to 169, and this I am shifting here, so that is 25. So AB is equal to 5. Okay, so what the side we were not having, now we have it AB, because we want the terms in form of sec and tan. So if sine is 12 by 13, so cos will be adjacent by hypo, means 5 by 13. So sec is inverse 13 by 5. Now we have sine and cos both. So tan theta is equal to sine by cos theta, that is 12 by 13 upon 5 by 13. Now, so that means 13 cut, we have value 12 by 5. These are our values, and now we will keep it in our given question. Okay, so sec theta plus tan theta upon sec theta minus tan theta. Okay, so sec theta is 13 by 5 plus 12 by 5 whole by 13 by 5 minus 12 by 5. Our denominators are same, no need to take LCM. 13 plus 12 by 5 whole upon 13 minus 12 by 5. Okay, so 13 and 12, that is 25 by 5, and this is 1 by 5. Okay, so the value we got our question, that is 25. Understood? It's very easy question, and this kind of questions we will have to solve more, because in exam this kind of question could be asked in very much short questions of 1 marks or 2 marks. Next question, find the value of 5 by cos square theta minus 5 by cot square theta. So here 5 by cot square theta, that could be 5 into 10 square theta, because we know 1 by cot, it is 10. So 5 by cot, that is 5 tan theta, minus 5 by cos square theta, that is 5 sec square theta. 5 common, 10 square theta minus sec square theta, so that is identity only, 10 square theta minus sec square theta is equal to 1. So our value we got, that is 1. Okay, this question is asked in CBSE 2009 in very short answer for 1 mark. Next question, if sine 3 theta is equal to cos theta minus 6, find theta, where 3 theta and theta minus 6 are acute angles. Okay, so we will have to find the value of theta, that could be also of acute angle only. So first we will take this sine 3 theta minus cos theta minus 6 degree. We will use the complementary angles. So here I am writing cos 90 minus 3 theta minus 6. Okay, that is the identity, 90 minus theta. Cos 90 minus theta, that is sine only. So 3 theta is equal to 90 minus theta minus minus plus 6. Okay, here we will have to write cos 90 minus theta is equal to sine theta. Okay, so sine side, both the side will be reduced. 3 theta, this theta I am transporting, so that will be plus theta, and now 90 plus 6, that is 96. So 4 theta is equal to 96. So theta is equal to 96 by 4, and that is 24 degree. Okay, so theta is equal to the value we have got, that is 24 degree, and that is only acute angles, which was the condition given in the questions.